Ladies and gentlemen, now moving forward to our last speaker session for this evening. We have Mr. Shantiswarup Panda. He is CMO Raymond's Lifestyle Business. Mr. Panda has over 16 years of experience across sectors like utility, automation, personal care, white goods and fashion. Have handled roles ranging across technology, sales and marketing, having worked in Infosys, Unilever. Currently, he is the Chief Marketing Officer at Raymond, responsible for the brand strategy and transformation. Mr. Panda, I request you to please come and join me on stage. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome him with a big round of applause.
Yeah, thank you for the introduction. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Quite an inspiring, set of sessions. I went through coffee. Very inspiring story, Reebok, very interesting story, Micromax, and I am here to present the story of Raymond. Possibly Raymond is the oldest brand amongst the four that we are going to hear about today. It's a 93-year-old brand, and the story that I'm going to present today evening is about how do you operate in a category of fashion and still reinvent stuff and make it relevant for the younger generations. I think the last presentation on Micromax was quite inspiring because Shubhadeep actually spoke about how do you keep reinventing and coming back to the consumers in terms of what they love and keep offering them. We are in the business of fashion, and fashion is exactly the same. So today my story is being a gentleman is never out of fashion, and that's what Raymond has always stood for. So Raymond, when it started in 1925, it's a homegrown brand. Started in India, started with blanket manufacturing, and we took it across the world. Very few people in the room would actually know that today Raymond is the largest manufacturer of worsted fabric in the world, the manufacturer of the best worsted fabric in the world, one of the largest manufacturer of denim. So all the denim that you wear of any brand possibly is actually manufactured in Raymond setup, while we supply it to other brands, both nationally and globally. We are the fifth largest manufacturer of suits and jackets globally. So we supply to JCPenney, Macy's, you name it in Europe, US, Japan, we are the largest suppliers. Brand name is somebody else's. So this is Raymond, starting from blanket, going up to a global stage. A brand which is known for its quality, trust, and excellence over the years. Now, where did we start this journey? And people who have spent most of their time in India, I'm sure they would have used Raymond at some point in time, whether now, during an interview, during a job opportunity, during wedding, reception, one of the milestone occasions in their life, they would have interacted with Raymond. So I would just start by playing a couple of videos and would try and build a story of saying what happened to Raymond and how did we came out of the spot of irrelevance that we were getting into as a brand, where everything outside in the consumer world was changing. And we took some time to kind of discover it for ourselves and then work on it and come out and operate with much more vigor and the enthusiasm as a brand and a company right now. So can I have the first two videos? Yeah, so these are just two films of the many, many films that we had created over 12, 13 years. And what it spoke about is the complete man. And what it created for the brand essentially is a personality who is caring, who is empathetic, who is trustworthy. And this is what created brand love. Many speakers before me actually spoke about brand love. This also created certain attributes for the brand and the product, which is the brand would stand for excellence, would stand for quality, and which came across all the campaigns that we did. And finally, Raymond always stood for something called trust, a lot of trust. And consumers knew it in their heart that their best moments are the moments where they need Raymond, and Raymond will be their ally there. So I think this is what Raymond was all about, and this was a beautiful journey. But something was happening outside, in the outside world. And that is what became disruption for us as a possibly 80-year-old company then. And what was changing in the consumer world? Interestingly, casualization was a big, big mega trend happening in men's clothing. Why men's, even women's clothing? Instant gratification with ready-mades coming in. So I don't know how many people in the room, especially men in the room, would actually get their shirts or trousers stitched is a big question. That's a task for us in the company as a market development to figure out how do we make tailoring more sexy going forward. So instant gratification with ready-mades coming in was a big, big mega trend. Occasion-based dressing, huge mega trend. People will decide what they wear for specific occasions and they will not choose the same ensemble for another occasion. Office is very different from weekend, is very different from party, is very different from lounge wear, is very different from vacation. They will have different sets of clothes. Entry of a lot of global brands. Global brands brought a lot of aspiration, a lot of brand value, and consumers really got attracted to a lot of global brands out there. And finally, mix and match as a trend. So no longer, you know, a set pattern of, you know, being a gentleman was accepted in the society. People started doing mix and match in terms of what shirt they want, what trouser they want, shoes, belts, watches, everything became fashion. And this is what was changing in the outside world, in the consumer world. And what happened to Raymond? If you look at, our brand got repositioned. And what happened? This became a brand meant for special occasion, only for, say, interviews, for weddings, for big meetings, etc., for very formal occasions, and nothing beyond it. All okay? Sorry. Also, what happened is, because of all the foreign brands coming in, casualization coming in, Raymond was not considered the most stylish or innovative brand. In fact, we have met consumers who would actually articulate Raymond as my dad's brand, not my brand. I love the brand, great brand, trust, everything fine, but it's my dad's brand, not suitable for me. And finally, it's a formal suits brand, which means Raymond is not associated with anything else in the fashion world. Now, this is what happened to Raymond when the consumer world was changing. And what happened? The complete man actually became a very conventional person, a person who more or less plays by the rules of the game and not goes beyond the boundaries drawn outside. And this is what happened. But what was happening outside to the consumer world? So if you look at the millennials and you speak to them, they are a very secure lot. They know what exactly they want to do. They might change their mind 2 months after they would have planned something. They are okay to accept failures as small milestones in their big something in future. So for them, playing by the rule or by the book is something that they don't associate with at all. And so there was a disconnect between the brand and the consumer out there. So what did we do? At Raymond, we believe in the three pillars of our brand, and we reimagined how do we create a brand which gives sustainable business for the company. So let me talk to you about the three pillars of the brand. The first pillar that we really hold very close to our hearts is actually the product. And Raymond is one company which is obsessed with product quality. And we believe in getting the finest and the best in class for the consumers in India. The second pillar of success for us is retail. I don't know, very many people may or may not know in the room that Raymond is the single largest retail brand in India. We have over 1,000 individual stores of Raymond in the country, which no other brand can claim to have. So physical retail is a point where we can really talk to consumers, interact with consumers, deliver experience to consumers, which will be way different from what they expect from other brands. And the third strength is actually the brand communication, or the brand, what the brand stands for. How do we create brand love for the consumers who has actually lost touch with the brand? So what we did is, we started with product, because unless you start working on product, you're not going to connect to a consumer who has already moved on to some other products, and they don't even imagine buying a Raymond. So what we did is, we started capturing all occasions. Rather than being, you know, slotted for a brand which is a suits brand, we said we should occupy all occasions or all slices of life. So we started innovating on product front. So now you would see Raymond beyond formals, into casuals, party wear. You will find lounge wear, you will find weekend wear, you will find possibly vacation wear. We are still not in sports wear, but we are going there. We also started capturing usage extension. So whichever occasion you talk about, Raymond started innovating on accessorization. So all the accessories that a man can think of, the full wardrobe strategy as we call it. So you talk of belts, shoes, leather bags, pocket squares, tie clips, everything that a man needs for every occasion was part and parcel of Raymond's offering. And so this is what changed essentially for Raymond. So if you look at early, we were basically about a formal wear and tailoring. From there, the current landscape is we are targeting almost all occasions beyond possibly sportswear for men. And we have our own offerings of custom tailoring, made to measure, made to fit kind of services. Essentially what this tells is, we under one roof want to offer all solutions possible for all your occasions of life. So it has to be a destination store for consumers. Can you just play the video? Can you play the video? Full wardrobe. So I'll just show you one video, just go back, which talks about product innovation, full wardrobe. Just click that link. So these are handcrafted shoes, what we call the made-to-measure shoes. Essentially, you can choose the leather, the color, the combination, the style, and it will be crafted to your size, your customized size. And that's the capability that Raymond has. So we really worked hard on the product front. Now, what was happening on the retail front? As I said, we are the largest retail format today. But most of it is actually asset-light, which is franchisee-led stores. So we started moving our retail from location where possibly the old world used to shop to location which is shopping destination for the younger generation. Give a simple example, possibly malls, redesign the store, get new age stores and present the stores and products in the store where consumers would like to come, experience the product and possibly spend time exploring fashion. And that's the idea. So I'll play a video for you. This is people who are from Bangalore can go to our Indranagar store. And this is the retail design that we are ushering in now across. And possibly this is the retail of future for us. Can you just play the video? Yeah, so this is what we want to convert every retail store that we have in India. It takes time, it takes investment, so it will take its own time. But this is how we see the future of retail for fashion in India. So this was retail. And the third leg, of course, is beyond this, is the whole brand story. How do you make the brand relevant for the consumers of today? Where we were talking about a complete man, possibly a guy who is very conventional, who takes pride in being Indian. At the same time, you have a set of consumers today, possibly they are more proud of being Indian today than we were as a previous generation, but they have their own ways of manifestation. The rituals have changed. And that is what we are trying to code and capture in our new set of creatives in the complete man. So a new set of complete man, if you understand the nuances here, is a personality who is possibly much more progressive, forward-looking, a guy who pushes the boundary, a guy who has a thought process of his own, but he's not an activist. He's not preachy. And so I'll try and show you a couple of creatives on this, if you can show the video of last three, four campaigns that we have done on complete man, which will give you the drift of the direction that we are taking actually on the thematic campaign. Can I have the video? Yep. So this was in 2016. This was a digital film. And interestingly, we repositioned the complete man as not a gender, but essentially a soul with a certain thought process. And that's what we did with this film. And we have a new one possibly coming on 15th August. So this was on thematic. And if you look at what changed essentially is we started curating stories which were aspirational, but connected possibly to the 30, 35 something of today. This was not a guy who was sacrificing his life for everybody around him. This was a guy, possibly he has his own moments of self-indulgence. This was a guy who wanted to have a little bit of fun. And this is somebody who cherishes those small moments or happy moments in life. And that's what the complete man of today is all about. Then we change the narrative and push the envelope a little further through our product innovation films, which were presented. So I don't know, many of you would have seen a lot of films, but I will play two, and these are little older films. So I'm not playing Khadi because many of you would have seen Khadi film. Can you play the videos? So these are some of the films we started advertising product because we wanted to talk to consumers in terms of our offering. And this is a linen film. Yeah, so if you see the codes, we tried to reposition ourselves from a black, gray, blue suits brand to much more vibrant linen, the best in the world, Supima cotton, possibly the homegrown khadi line of fashionable, you know, ensemble for men, and services made to measure. Everything there was actually made to measure. That's the whole idea of that film, is how do you create something which is such a perfect fit for the guy, from the jacket to a denim. He was actually wearing a denim trouser, belts, shoes, personal monogram out there. And that's what we were talking to consumers. So essentially, with all the three pillars, we have started seeing some green shoots. And this is interesting for me to kind of share with the audience here. So when we look at a younger TG, I'm not talking to typically a Raymond consumer would be a 38, 40 or 40 plus guy. But this data actually, and I think IMRB guys are here, right? So they do a lot of research for us. This is for 25 to 34 year old, a much younger TG. And if I look at cut of all the mind measures which the brand wanted to achieve, whether it is being youthful, being more fashionable, being much more modern, technology driven, all these attributes were moving season on season for us. If you look at it, the brand strength, actually both awareness is almost 100%. That's not an issue, and it's never an issue for Raymond. But on trials and conversions and loyalty, the pyramid is becoming stronger over seasons. For the same TG, this is the younger TG. If you look at some more results, last year, I don't think any other brand in any category would have added 100 exclusive stores in this country. We added 100 plus stores in India last year, which means consumers are coming, buying, they're enjoying their experience with Raymond. We have added 1.5 million users to our database who have joined our loyalty program only last year, and there is a huge database before that. Also, it, you know, eventually it pays when you do the right things, and so last year possibly was one of the best years for us. So if I look at only domestic business, I'm not stating domestic and international, we saw double digit growth for the business on top line and almost close to 30% growth on EBITDA. So I think some of these green shoots are really encouraging for us as a team, and our effort is essentially to again focus on product, retail, and communication, and ensure that we reimagine Raymond and paint a new Raymond and offer a completely new submersive experience for the consumer, that they come back and enjoy their experience with Raymond. So I think that's all from my side on the Raymond story. Thank you so much for patiently listening to me.